గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్ లేడీస్ అండ్ జెంటిల్మెన్. ఐఎమ్ రియలీ హ్యాపీ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూఆర్ హియర్. యూ స్పెండ్ సమ్ టైమ్ ఇన్ ఇన్వెస్టింగ్ సమ్ టైమ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ద కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఫుడ్స్ దట్ యూ ఈట్ అండ్ వాట్ కెన్ బి డన్ విత్ ఇట్. ఐ రియలీ థ్యాంక్ ద ఎమినెంట్ స్పీకర్స్ ఆన్ ద స్టేజ్, డాక్టర్ దయాకర్ ప్రసాద్ గారు, రాంబాబు గారు, ఉమాదేవి మేడం, లక్ష్మీ మేడం, ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ హ్యావ్ బిన్ అట్ ఎవ్రీ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ మై లైఫ్, అట్ ఎవ్రీ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ యూనో ఇన్ ద జర్నీ ఆఫ్ హెల్త్ సూత్ర. దే హ్యావ్ బిన్ దేర్, దే హ్యావ్ బిన్ కాంట్రిబ్యూటింగ్ టు ద బ్రాండ్స్ గ్రోత్. See, I think what I'll try to do is I'll try to, all of the speakers have spent a lot of time giving you information on why millets are good, what is the market scenario of millets, what can be done with them, in what seasons do you have millets, in what times of life do you have millets, why should you have millets, how millets are better. Yeah, all of these points have been covered. I would like to put a slightly different twist on why we are here today. We have started Health Sutra in 2014. You know, I was just a young engineer, passed out of college, worked for a few years, quit my job, went to Dr. Dayakar's office, met Dr. Lakshmi. I told them I want to do something in millets. What do I do in millets? Why millets? Then, at that point of time, a lot of people were asking the question, what are millets? I think we have come to a stage in the past 5 years. Now the question is, how do we use millets? Which basically means that the awareness levels in the consumers have increased. Consumers are now wanting to know what should be done with these millets. How can these millets be used? What are the different recipes that can be made from these millets? Which basically means consumers are becoming more and more aware. So what we try to understand is, we try to understand two things at Health Sutra. We try to understand what is it that is making consumers more aware? What are these drivers of awareness? So we've identified that the first driver is fear. People are scared, yeah. They're scared that they're getting diabetes. They're scared that they might become really, really fat. They're scared that they might be getting, you know, high cholesterol. They're scared that their father already has it, someone else in their family already has it, they are scared they might get it. And they're looking at food to help solve their problem. They're looking at food that can help them fight, that can somehow act as a preventive medicine of sorts. At the same time, especially over the past 2 years, a distinctive trend has emerged where there are lots of influencers talking about millets. Not just millets, healthy eating in general. Let's put millets aside for the time being. Let's talk about why people are choosing healthy food more and more. One is fear. The second one is the influence of influencers, or the influencers like movie stars are talking about detox drinks. Corporate stalwarts are talking about healthier eating. People are talking about making a 45-minute walk a daily part of your life. The third thing is, while people want to eat healthy, what we've understood is that they're still trying to look at options that are either ready to cook or ready to eat, which basically means that they want something convenient. In Hyderabad, for example, a statistic says 30% households have both husband and wife working. In a house where both the husband and wife are working, there is very little time left for cooking. Who's there to cook? Someone has to be there who has to do the elaborate preparation. So something that can be made instantly, something that can, you know, save time for the mother, is something that people are looking at. And one more interesting thing that emerged, I distinctly remember, when I was young, my father used to take me to this place called Pondi Bazaar in Chennai. Pondi Bazaar was really famous for smuggled imported stuff. You know, imported stuff used to be really, really popular. It used to be high in demand. We used to spend extra money to buy imported stuff. Imported stuff was aspirational for people, right? So what has happened, especially over the past 3-4 years or 5 years, you can say, is that Indian stuff has become fashionable. Indian stuff, desi stuff, has become aspirational. And you can see that rise in the rise of Patanjali, brands like Patanjali. People are looking at something that's native and are willing to pay extra money for it. They're not saying it's native, it's local, it's cheap, so take less money. No. I'm willing to pay more. So we feel these are the four broad factors: fear, influences, wanting something that's convenient and easy to use, and willing to pay a premium for, you know, something that is local, something that is native. And these are all backed by numbers, you know, we are not really giving you gyan out here. And if you come back and try to understand, what are these drivers doing? Where are these leading us to? What they are saying is a basic simple thing. Start eating healthy, choose healthier foods, start making more informed conscious choices. And that's where grains like millet fit in. Millets, I think all of the people in this room are already convinced about the nutritional benefits of millets. But what is needed? So what we've done is, especially over the past 2 years, awareness about millets have risen. That's what I told, right? So we tried to go to the market, we tried to speak to customers and try to understand how are they eating millets. People are eating millets, millets are good for you, how are you eating millets? So I think our marketing team went, I think we spoke to close to about 650,000 customers, let's say. Yeah, and we tried to understand what is happening, and we found that about 30% on an average know about millets. They understand what millets can do for them. They understand the nutritional benefits, but they have not used millets even once. I'll give you one more statistic. About 40% have tried millets, have tried to make some rice out of it, have tried to make millet palu, you know, they've tried to make curd out of it, they've tried to do multiple things. 6 months after they've started using the millet, they've lapsed out. 40% of people who have started, who have made a conscious choice, wanted to use millets in their life, have lapsed out of using millets. So what we at Health Sutra try to do is we try to understand why is that happening? What is it that can make people make a healthy choice and stick to it? So we feel if products can be brought out with a combination of three factors. The product need to be tasty for sure. If no matter how healthy the product is, if it's not tasty, no one's going to continue using it. That's a plain and simple hard truth that we as a brand have learned. It needs to be tasty, 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 it needs to be tasty. Second thing, the fundamental value of it being healthy has to be there in the food. That's why we are choosing it in the first place. Third most important thing that we have identified is somehow the food that they choose has to fit into their traditional narrative. When I say traditional narrative, you wake up in the morning, what do you eat? In South India, we eat idlis, dosas, upmas. Yes? But is there an easy way to make a millet idli, millet dosa, millet upma without changing too much of what I already do? I am already used to making idli, dosa, upma. I am already, you know, I have committed myself to invest the time and effort to make these idli, dosas and upmas. Do I have something from millets that can help me make idlis, dosas or upmas or poha easily? We found that nothing like that is really available in the market. So somehow health is there, taste is a question mark, fitting into the traditional narrative is missing. And we tried to scan the supermarket shelves. Most of the products are made from either oats or quinoa. Now quinoa, you're finding lots of products. You take oats, oats is available as plain oats is available as steel cut oats is available as rolled oats is available as biscuits, oats is available as porridge, oats is available in dosa mix now. So you're basically taking the same ingredient and you're trying to create different formats, but all from the same ingredient. And 97%, I think, of India's oats are still imported. We don't really grow them in our country. Our country's climate, most of our country's climate doesn't really suit well to grow oats. Yeah, I think people there would agree. Yeah. Yes. So the challenge would then become to basically create a product out of the millet that, one, as Dayakar sir said, should not be overprocessed, should have their nutritional value still locked inside. The nutrition value has to be there, should be made tasty, and three, they most importantly need to fit into the traditional food narrative, which basically means you should be able to make your traditional dishes that are used to, dishes most importantly that your family is used to. Because what happened when we asked people why they stopped using millets after 6 months, the biggest answer that came is that their family did not like it. My son didn't like millets. I stopped. My husband didn't like millets. I stopped. So somehow, can we make it fun? Can we make it tasty? Can we make it convenient to use while ensuring that the nutrition remains intact? I think I believe strongly that at Health Sutra, we've been able to successfully do that. In the products that we do, there are certain core values, the values that I've mentioned. We try to keep them intact. And I'm really happy, Dr. Dayakarao, that you mentioned. Recently, we got these biscuits, tasted by a minister. And he couldn't really figure out until we told him that it's millet-based biscuit. They're so close to what you're already used to. You, when you see a biscuit, you expect subconsciously in your mind, there is some, neural network happening and saying that if you are eating a biscuit, this is how it is going to taste like, this is how it's going to feel like in your mouth, right? So, I think at Health Sutra, we try to basically create biscuits that are so close to something that you're already used to, yet ensuring that the nutrition and the taste remains intact. So that's what, I think I need not spend too much time explaining more. These are our forefathers' food. Millets are our forefathers' foods. That's what it's Kalidasa in Abhijnana Sakuntalam mentioned foxtail millet. That is how old they are. 5,000 years old foxtail millet noodles were found in China in an archaeological site. That's how old they are. They have been in India for 6,000, 7,000 years. Indus Valley civilization had millets. It's only in the past 30, 40 years, 50 years that we have slowly lapsed out. So I think there's nothing wrong in saying that millets are the heirloom that strong families pass on to the next generation. So if it's a family, along with wealth, you should pass on health. In the form of millets, which are our grains of India, which are our traditional foods. And at Health Sutra, we are doing our small little effort to take this narrative forward. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
మరిన్ని అప్డేట్స్ కోసం STV యూట్యూబ్ ఛానల్ను సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోండి.